here solid particles into liquid, how the diffusion takes place? We know diffusion property is not applicable to solids, but we can observe diffusion in liquids. That means solid particles in liquids. How? Jyotish, how?
If the ratio of diffusion gases is higher.
Jyotish, are you here?
Yes, teacher, I can hear, listen to your voice.
Yeah, tell me now.
So by heating.
By heating. So listen carefully here, all of you. Diffusion of solid particles. Into liquids. Okay. So here, see Nana, solids do not have diffusion property. They cannot move from one place to another place. Yes, sir?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Due to strong attraction between one particle to another particle. Okay, due to strong attraction between one particle to another particle and less gaps between one particle to another particle in solids, there is no diffusion property to these solids. But we can observe the diffusion of solids particles into liquids. How the diffusion takes place here? In a beaker, we have taken some water. Assume that if we are taking here 100 ml of water. Into this, if you are added some sugar crystals or potassium permanganate crystals or salt crystals, so all these are in the solid form. Okay? So here, okay, assume that you are taking 1 tablespoon of salt in this beaker or sugar in this beaker. So here, after some time, does this sugar dissolve in this water or not? Oh, you cannot talk, no?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Okay. Right. So here, the sugar particles completely dissolved in this water. We cannot see here sugar particles in this water now. We observe one clear solution. Where is the sugar particles? When we add it, at first, we can see the sugar particles. But after some time, when we stir that solution by using a spoon, the sugar particles continuously dissolve in that water. Finally, we will not observe any sugar particles in that water. We will see only water here. One clear solution we observe. Then where is the sugar particles now? Where is the sugar particles? Okay, you will say here, sugar particles are dissolved. But why we are not seeing here sugar particles? Where it goes? Here, we know liquids have gaps between one particle to another particle. Okay, liquids have gap between one particle to another particle. So, here, whatever the sugar we are taking, sugar is in the solid form, no? So, here, when sugar particles are dissolved, they occupy the space between the liquid particles. Now, the solution becomes even. That means it looks like unique. clear solution or homogeneous solution, we can say. So that's why we are not observing the any sugar particles in this. The sugar particles are occupied the gaps between the liquid particles. So that's why it is one of the clear solution here. We can say here solid particles are diffused in liquid. Here solid is diffusing in the liquid. Nana. Okay, are you understood this one? Here, how the diffusion takes place, we have to say liquid particles have gaps between one particle to another particle. So whatever the solids we are taken into liquids, when they are dissolved, they occupy the spaces between the liquid particles. For example, Nana, if you are taken in a beaker, water, and sand. Now, what will happen here? Anyone tell? Does this sand dissolves in this water?
It's not dissolved. The sand particles occupy the space between the water.
Anna, here, okay, you are taking sand particles, first of all. After some time, can we see the sand particles in this water or not?
No, teacher. You can't see.
Sand dissolves in water?
Little bit.
No, teacher, it is not dissolved.
Right, very good. Yes, sand does not dissolve in water.
Will not dissolve, teacher. Sand will not dissolve in water.
Yeah, it will keep 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days. It will not dissolve here. Sand does not dissolve in water. If you are taking sand in water, sand deposited to the bottom of the beaker. Okay, above it, water layer will be formed. Sand anedi beaker kindiki vellipothundi. Sand teeskondi. వాటర్ తీసుకోండి ఓకేనా ఏమవుతుంది ఒక 1 అవర్ తర్వాత చూడండి ఇలా 2 అవర్ తర్వాత చూడండి ఆ శాండ్ అంతా కూడా బీకర్ కానీ గ్లాస్ కానీ తీసుకుంటే దాని కిందికి వచ్చేస్తుంది పైన అంతా కూడా క్లియర్ గా వాటర్ కనిపిస్తుంది ఆ వాటర్ ని మనం ఈజీగా సెపరేట్ చేయొచ్చు దాన్ని శాండ్ అనేది మీరు 1 డే పెట్టినా 2 డేస్ పెట్టినా ఎన్ని డేస్ పెట్టినా అది డిజాల్వ్ అవ్వదు ఓకేనా ఇక్కడ ఇది డిజాల్వ్ అవ్వదు శాండ్ అనేది సో హియర్ విల్ నాట్ అబ్జర్వ్ ఎనీ డిఫ్యూజన్ ప్రాపర్టీ ఆఫ్ శాండ్ పార్టికల్స్ ఇన్ వాటర్ Okay, so we can observe in sugar particles and salt particles and some other solid particles are there. So we'll observe in that diffusion property. Okay, then we can say at that time when they dissolve, they occupy the spaces between the solid particles, liquid particles. That is the reason. And we can observe diffusion property in liquids to liquids. Diffusion of Already we discussed this one. Liquid into liquid. Take one beaker. Take some amount of water in this. Okay. To this add red color ink or green color ink, whatever the color, add 2 to 3 drops of ink or any color. What will happen? That 2 to 3 drops of ink will completely dissolve in this water. Okay? That dissolves in this water, we can observe completely colored water after some time. Will not observe water. Okay, so here that liquid particles again have a gap between one particle to another particle. So because of that, whatever the ink we are taking, just 2 to 3 drops, that 2 to 3 drops of water is occupied the gaps between the liquid particles here. So that's why we observe the diffusion of liquids here into liquids. And we can also observe diffusion of gases into liquids. Okay, gases also diffused in the liquids. Nana, how means this carbon dioxide gas and oxygen gas, they dissolved in the water. When oxygen gas, carbon dioxide dissolved in water, then only the aquatic animals can survive their life. Otherwise, not. Okay. In in water, so many animals will live. Aquatic animals, like plants also live in the water. How they live? When oxygen gas and carbon dioxide gas dissolves in water, then only the aquatic animals can live in water, or otherwise not. They also need oxygen and carbon dioxide to live. So here, oxygen and carbon dioxide gases dissolves in water. So that one is a diffusion of gases in liquids. So here we can observe the diffusion of property here. Gases into liquids, liquid into liquids, and solid into liquids. Okay, we can see diffusion of gases into liquids and diffusion of liquids into liquids and diffusion of solid into liquids and diffusion of gases into gases. Okay,